Hi, I'm Jill. I'm a technician and I'm the blood bank director at DoveLewis. Today we're going to talk about making a selection of blood products that are available depending on what your patient needs. This is a unit of whole blood, and that's what comes out of the dog or cat as you draw it. It has all of the clotting factors in it. It has red cells, it has platelets, it has plasma proteins. Everything that is in the dog is in this product. As long as it is not refrigerated, the platelets are still viable. As soon as you put it in the fridge, the platelets become not viable, so you cannot transfuse it for a patient that needs platelets. We put this product in the centrifuge and separate it out into packed red blood cells and plasma. If the centrifuge is chilled, then the platelets are not going to be in the plasma. If you do need platelets, then you can warm the centrifuge and spin it down, and then you have platelet-rich plasma. And then the next line down the road is you can take the plasma and freeze it and then thaw it and put it in the centrifuge, and you can get cryoprecipitate out of it. So cryoprecipitate is a concentration of clotting factors. It's a concentration of von Willebrand's factor, anti-hemophilia A, factors 8 and 13. And then if you pull out most of the plasma, leaving just a little bit left with the cryoprecipitate, then you have cryopoor plasma. Cryopoor plasma has the rest of the clotting factors in it. So you can keep cryoprecipitate for 1 year from the blood draw, and you can keep cryopoor plasma for up to 5 years from the blood draw. Whole blood is great for whole blood losses. Severe trauma is an example. When an animal is literally bleeding on the pavement, you need to give them their whole blood back. Another case would be an acute bleed, maybe from a ruptured mass. They will need a whole blood transfusion because of that. Going down the line for packed red blood cells, it's just for an anemia replacement. So if they need oxygen carrying capacity, they need their red cells back, then that's why they would need the packed red blood cells. Plasma has proteins in it, though it's kind of going out of favor doing transfusions just for proteins, but it also has those clotting factors in it. And so it's when it's fresh frozen plasma is plasma that has only been thawed within 1 year from the collection date, and that has all the clotting factors in it. So if you have an animal with liver failure and you're not really sure what clotting factors are missing, then you want to use the fresh frozen plasma that's within 1 year from the draw. If it's been stored for longer than a year, it's just considered frozen plasma, not fresh frozen plasma, and that has the non-liable clotting factors in it. So that's good for rat poison. It's pretty much just good for rat poison. And then down to the cryoprecipitate, because it has anti-hemophilia A factor in it and it also has von Willebrand's factor, it's great to use if preemptively in a surgery on a known von Willebrand's or hemophiliac patient. It's also able to use topically in surgery. If there is a bleed, you can just pour cryoprecipitate on the bleed and it's sterile and it'll stop the bleeding. But it's only effective for about 30 minutes to an hour, so you have to make sure that you can nick that bleed in the bud before they start bleeding again. The red cells can only be stored in the fridge. You don't want them in the freezer, and so as long as it's between 1 and 6 degrees Celsius, those are still good. Depending on what you use when you collect the blood as an anticoagulant, a lot of times they have an additive in them to feed the red cells, and depending on that additive, depends on how long it's going to last in the fridge. So ours are good for 6 weeks, some of them are only good for 4, and some of them are only for 2. So make sure whatever you're using, you're reading the label and storing it for the appropriate length of time. The plasma, as I said, is good for 1 year, and then you have to relabel it as frozen plasma, and then that's good for 4 additional years. When you keep it in the freezer, it has to be negative 18 degrees Celsius or lower. When you purchase plasma, it often comes as a frozen product. Depending on the size, the bigger units, 200 mils or more, they take about 30 minutes to thaw in a warm water bath. These smaller, like cryoprecipitate or feline units, also are tiny. They're only 20, 30 mils. They only take like 10 minutes to thaw in a warm water bath, or maybe a little bit longer on the counter. When you thaw plasma, the bags are very fragile, and so it's best to just stuff it into a plastic bag and then another plastic bag, so it's double bagged, and put it in the box, in the bag, into the water bath. If you take it out of the box before it's thawed, you can rupture the bag. Your warm water bath should not exceed 32 degrees Celsius because you can destroy some of the proteins that are in the product. And once you have this in the warm water bath, if it's more than 50% thawed, you don't want to refreeze it. If you just put it in and then something happens with the patient, you don't end up giving the transfusion and it's still mostly frozen, you can put it back in the freezer, but it's only considered frozen plasma at that point, not fresh frozen plasma. So choosing the right components for the right situation is really important for your patient. So when you call the blood bank, make sure that you know what the blood type of your patient is. And if you don't know, then the blood bank can often run that test for you. And then knowing what is wrong with your patient so you know which product to order, whether you need the whole blood or you can just choose the packed red blood cells or just the plasma.